this.
Led from her, afraid of becoming her next victim. Tefnu regarded them with a tinge of sadness, and both saw a look of disappointment in the book. Then, Malakakaka lifted his chin to the sky and saw the form of Law hovering in the clouds. Gold chalices filled with wine sat next to an overstuffed bed, wrapped up in soft linens. Tabubu handed him one of the chalices and sat back on the bed. The chamber was filled with light, and Setna could just make out Tabubu's figure through the thin gown she wore.
Dear Tabubu, I have traveled to the outer edges of your city to find you. I desire you more than anything I've ever felt in this world. Come to me now. Let us be one.
As much as you can, your desire.
Setna returned the Book of Filth from where he'd found it, on the chest of the corpse of Nanavakapta. With delight, enamored with Pandora, she was so beautiful, with such kind eyes, that they wanted to keep her for themselves. But Zeus would not forget his revenge.
A tad insolent,
but well. He failed at the mission of being a good wife to Epimetheus. Pandora wept openly, fearful of what would happen. She stared in disbelief. The dead man was moving. He was speaking. Earthgrilla, however, didn't seem the slightest bit perturbed, and she stepped forward to address the corpse.
Apologies for disturbing you, sir. We only wish to ask a question.
Ask me nothing, sorceress. I only bear ill tidings for you.
Earthgrilla, perhaps the dead are best undisturbed.
We wish only to know what creature lives in the forest yonder. What was it that brought about your death?
It is your death you should be concerned with, vile succubus. As you ripped me from the veil, so you shall be ripped asunder. I curse you. I curse you.
Crashed over Hadding's head and he fell. Before he could stand, his opponent seized him, carried him to the door, and threw him out into the night.
Let me go, you
dump!
Who are they? The Aenherir. Souls of great fallen warriors. Each day they face each other in battle. Each evening their wounds are healed and they join each other in a glorious...
Dropping beneath him, he was flying over the sea on the back of Sleipnir, the great horse of Odin. He had truly visited the hall of the Aesir.
Look at me, for this road is not for mortal eyes. When you awaken, you will find that you have been captured.